Hi, good evening. Namaskara, Bengaluru. I'm Archana from Work TV and welcome back to my show, Voice. Classical dance. You know, we have 8 different types of classical dance in India. And the first and most is Bharatanatyam, which is basically originated from Tamil Nadu. And this dance is performed with lot of beautiful gestures, lot of grace with a stunning costume and also a proper step to the beat, and which conveys a story or a theme or even a bhakti towards God. And today on my show, I have a very lovely, very charming person who happens to be my guru. Yes, she is my guru. I'm learning Bharatanatyam from her. She is she is an awardee of Best Classical Dancer Karnataka, and she's very graceful. She performs dance very beautifully. She has got that charisma which distinguish her from other dancers. And she says, dance is in her veins since she was 4 years old, and she puts her complete heart and soul into it. And yes, welcome my guru, welcome on my show, Ms. Shweta Vijay.
Thank you for inviting me in this show, and thanks for Work TV. I'm very happy. It's the first experience for me, first time experience. It's nice. What should I say? You know my name, Shweta Vijay. Yes. I stay in Dallas Colony. Yeah. I'm teacher, learner, both. I teach also, I learn also still. There is no end to it in classical dance. Like you said, 8 classical dances are there. If we like, we can learn all the 8s. 8-1. But my interest is on Bharatanatyam especially. I don't know how it has come. My grandfather, he recognized me. I don't know how he find it. But once he told, he may take me to the dance teacher. That time in my place, only one dance teacher was there. Is Vasudev Acharya, very strict person. Only Aramandi he used to do. If we don't do Aramandi, he will give nicely. He will throw where we are standing from his seat, half it should be 10 feet away. Still, he used to throw the stick if we don't sit half sitting. That much stick. Still, I don't know how the interest has come where my grandfather saw in me. Then same thing continue. My mother also gave full support to continue. After that, my husband, my father-in-law, mother-in-law, everybody. Now it's growing. I'm very happy what I'm doing. That is important. What I feel, many of them, when they see me, they saw me, they tell me that what you're doing, what you like. That is very most important in the life.
That's
when
very
I
true.
Was doing, I don't remember. I felt like that. But now I'm feeling, yes. What all are saying is right. Sometimes we realize this lately, that what really we want, what we are doing is right or wrong. But it's really happy that I'm doing what I'm presenting.
That's really sweet, and it's my honor that, you know, I got to talk to my guru. And I think many of will not get this opportunity to, you know, give an exposure to their guru or talk to them so freely, because that gap is there between a guru and, student. So
yes.
I must say I am lucky that I've got you, such a wonderful guru like you, and I'm talking to you. So why Bharatanatyam? Why didn't you choose any other dance? Okay, I understood that your grandfather wanted you to, made you start this dance, learn this dance form. When you started this, didn't you feel any time that you want to change your dance form? Or there are many.
Yeah, 100%. When I was a kid, I did not feel. I thought every dance is a dance. I don't know what is classical dance that time. I used to do all the form of dance. I used to do folk. I used to do Marathi. I used to do Western. Every dance is a dance. That's the only I know in my mind. I have to dance. When the music I hear, I used to dance. You don't believe, bathroom also I tried, walking way in the road, street, everywhere dancing only. But when the stage comes, like after we mature, we grow up, sometimes we realize ourselves. what is best, what is right. That is one part. We are dancing for everything. When it strikes on us, then we feel like, yes, Bharatanatyam is for me, meant for me. I meant for that. Like that time I felt that, yes, this is a perfect, only I have to go for Bharatanatyam. That's it. I don't want anything to learn. That time I felt, yes, I was in maybe college. I used to give more performance and I used to participate all the shows and all. Then I used to go simultaneously folk and Western also. I thought, Western also nice. It is very energetic. I don't know what it takes in the future, nothing. Just I want to dance that time. Then after many shows, I realized, yeah, this is classical based. It is connected to God. I don't know how it came to my mind. Then I thought, yes, one I have to make. That this is the one right thing, what I'm doing. I'm happy to do. And it is connected to God, which I always enjoy when I do. When I do bhajan, I'll enjoy. When I'm free time, I'll do. Then I'll enjoy. Same thing when I do dance. Saying bhajan, like that only I'll dance with the expression, with this. So it is inside me, I thought. Then I told, I don't need to go any other try. This, what I'm enjoying, I'm doing, no? So no need other things. Then Bharatanatyam, fixed.
But that's so nice. So in class, we don't talk much. We don't get time to talk. Don't have so much freedom on stage to ask you so many things. So I want to know, what are your hobbies or interests other than dancing?
Basically, I'm a positive thinker, energetic, jovial. So except dance, I do everything. Like whenever I get time, I play badminton. If I get time, swimming. If I get time, cooking properly I have to do. So singing, bhajan. Every day I have to do bhajan. That will give me more happy and peace. So that is also one of the hobby I can say. Mainly whenever I get time, I keep on doing all my this, whatever I said, I'll do it. Except dance is every time. There is no break. Except this is the some hobbies. Reading story also, I like it.
Okay, that's nice. So since you have pursued the degree in this Bharatanatyam, I'm sure you know everything in detail, but a little information.
I don't know everything. I'm learning still. There is no end to it.
Yeah. Do you know any history of this dance form, like from where it started, what's its importance, how does it help for, stay healthy, and why most of the Indians parents insist a female child to, start off with Bharatanatyam? So why is that?
What I read, I'm reading. For my exams also, it is there. All kids also reading when they give for exams, Bharatanatyam exam, when they go. Like Natya Veda, before. Like when Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Matsya, like that started in the everywhere. So it has to be controlled. There is no other thing than this. No happiness. Only mercy, fighting, jealousy. So what I read is, then that time Brahma thought that there should be some other thing to control all these things, evil emotions. So Brahma thought that I have to create one more Veda, that is called Natya Veda. So he already started to take from Rig Veda 1, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda, Atharvana Veda. So he selected speech, music and emotions, rasa. So he joined together and he made a Natya Shastra. Same thing, year goes. About the Bharatanatyam, 2000 year ago, it started in Tamil Nadu. It started growing from the small place, Tanjavur, like that, small villages, they started growing. Like the beginner of the, what I can say is Satriya, Sadra community, they started dancing for the god, Devadasis, what we say. And only they used to dedicate themselves for the god. They used to dance like for the god only we have to dance. We have fully for him. Like that they used to do, that community used to do. Like that slowly it started spreading everywhere. after some year ago, they stopped, government stopped, everything happened. But culture is culture, which is right, it will come again. Now, it is again started to flourish. Everybody started, now, even though in this time, everybody like health habit is not proper, not properly sleeping, they're not doing any extra exercises, curricular activities. So some of the other routes they have to choose. So most of them, the kids always prefer dance, Bharatanatyam. Not even Bharatanatyam, all the kind of dance, which gives happy, laughing, controlling, angry, hungry. And even though you can maintain your healthy diet plus your body, whatever you do exercise, it will give you proper shape. So I think it is again increasing the value of classical dances. I am very happy. It's happening.
Yes, that is, even I am happy that I am part of it, and I want to learn more and more, you know. I must say those Devdasis are incredible women who devoted themselves to God. So that was a lot many information which even I was not aware of. So
many is there, yes.
Yeah. What is the biggest challenge, or when did you face the biggest challenge in this dancing journey? Because you have performed across India. So,
no challenge in the sense I cannot say. When I was young, I used to learn properly, but there is very lack of exposure. Small town, only temple, that also rarely we used to get. I used to wait when my guru will give next chance for me to perform. Till senior overs, we never used to get the perform chance. Then we used to wait, what is performance? How we have to face the stage? How it will be? How we will feel when we face it? So I always, some batches of the girls, we always wait, when we'll get to perform? When we will get to perform? So that time, very less opportunity to perform and we to show our talent. Why we give our show? Because when we show it, we'll get a reaction, like how it is. Then we'll feel happy. So other feels happy means we'll feel happy. So it will together happiness, spreading the happiness. So like that, so we always like to give performance. So there's very lack that time. Slowly, slowly, when it increased, when I come to Bangalore, then I started giving programs. Then my dreams come true like that. I used to give everyday programs. Then I realized, oh, this is called giving performance and seeing the people, and they are loving the classical dance. They are encouraging. And like sometimes they feel like we are seeing the God only like that. If we do like a Parvati dance or any kind of a God dance, some villages we were performed, they feel like, oh, you are only God. They have put the mala and they were praising that. That all points gives so much happy that yes, we are doing a good thing, like very good thing like that. Other than that, opportunity. Whatever government are supporting, sometimes all the teachers and students will not get scholarships, beneficiaries. We don't aware of like what is there for cultural side, what scheme they are giving. Improvement, what improvement they are implementing, we don't know. Sometimes we come to know from website or somebody will tell, will try to put it or try to get it. But that is what, some lack is there for traditional culture followings and all.
That's so, the main challenge you mean to say.
Yes, yes, yes. So really, in dance, teachers, they face very much struggle. They don't get help very fast. Even this COVID time also, so many teachers are depending on the dance, cultural, what they do, so much work they do. In this month, everything stopped. I don't know how they did for eating every day, for bread, so much. We don't know. If somebody settled for some way or the other way, they can manage easily. If really they are depending on it completely, means it is very, very difficult. And how much it is reached to them from the government, that also we don't know. So there and here, we can find all these things.
Okay. So that is the main challenge, I guess. I hope government brings in, you know, a lot of opportunities to cultural dances.
100%.
So, what is your dream? What is your future plans? Do you have any goal?
Continuing dance only the goal, main goal. I think I have to do a good dance class, in the sense dance institute where everybody has to get the facility, like whatever government also trying, same thing. Like if scholarship is getting, I have to give to my students. They have to happily use it and they have to happily continue it. Same thing my student we should do to their student. That, that confidence we should get. That I want to do when I properly build a proper institute like branches and all. First, we are in just slow steps. It has to go more. Then only I can do all these things. So plans are very much in this field.
You're starting a dancing school, basically. Yes. Bharatanatyam dancing, dance form.
Yeah. Yes.
So, how was that feeling when you received the Best Dancer Award for Karnataka? I know you'll be the happiest.
No, award in the sense, we give so many programs. Like, it is a honor. It's a honor, whatever we get now after the dance, it is like an award only. Not if it is a small or it is a big. I feel like, yes, this is an achievement. That is like there is no end to it for the happiness. That's it. Higher we want, not like that. But it is, if you get small also, that we feel happy. Yes, something we are getting for our good things like that.
So, how are you as a mother? You're very passionate. I see, the way you are with your son in between the classes. So how are you as a mother?
How can I say, when if you ask my son, he will answer properly. Even though I love my son. Meanwhile, I'm very strict too, because it's our responsibility how we have to grow our son, like to making a best human for this society. If we teach now what is right, what is bad, then he will do the same thing for in the society. Now, many things happen, good also, bad also. But they should not choose a bad way when they grow. In the small, we will leave it like that. Okay, do whatever we want. But when they grow, we cannot correct them. So I am very jovial with him. I'll play, I'll enjoy, I do my duty together. Half day class, half day his study, like that. Meanwhile, nicely we'll fight also. So it's very nice. That we'll get when we become mother. Then only we'll realize it. Yes, this is called mother. We cannot get angry also. We have to balance both the things. That also we'll learn when we face it.
True.
All things I faced and now it is balanced, I feel. I don't know.
I know how much you are fond of babies and kids. Yeah. I've seen that. So, that was a lot many information about you and dance. So, I'll ask you a few funny questions, like rapid fire questions. You can answer them with one word. Okay.
Okay. So, okay.
Have you ever sent a message or a text to wrong person? And you have realized, oh, later, I did mistake, kind of.
No, not happened. Maybe one time. No, I don't. Maybe in the class it maybe happened. Like one group I will send 4:00. Some other group, no, not for you. I have to send to other group. That timing differentiation for the taking the class, that maybe happened 2 times by mistakenly.
Okay. So if you could make one rule, and if you get a chance to make one rule, what it would be?
One rule.
Rule.
Rule. Mm-hmm. Rule. Many are there. I don't know. Always I will be pinpointing government. Always I pinpointing apartment rules. Always I pinpointing many things. It is, there is no one rule. So many rules are there.
So what it would be? What is that one thing you want to, you know, make everyone obey?
Everyone obey? What rule I'll make? I'll make everybody to follow the fitness in eating and time sense discipline, like a military people. Discipline, no laziness. Sleep only in the night time, not in the morning time. That rule I'll make definitely.
Okay.
Then so, our country will grow like anything.
True, very true. So, what was your other option other than becoming a dancer?
Other was, I was working in SpiceJet.
Oh,
so if I would have continued, means I would have become trainer. No, I have been selected as a trainer, also grooming instructor in ground level. I would have promoted more, like in a manager level or in the SpiceJet team level. I would have grown like that.
Okay.
But I am happy what I am now. But there was a good option also at that time when I quit. I was supposed to be appointed as a manager level team. That time only I quit. Meanwhile, I used to do dance also simultaneously. I never quit dance. I did not give any break. I keep on doing.
Okay. So next one is, if you have only two choices, either you have to keep running or either you have to keep skipping. Which one would you choose?
What? I have to keep running or?
Suppose skipping.
Okay, skipping. Yeah.
You have skipping only two options.
Okay. One is skipping.
Yeah.
What more is?
One is running.
No, skipping is better. I'll do better. Yeah. I keep on doing. I love it. Nowadays, we forgot everything, I feel.
Okay. So, if you get a power of reading somebody else's mind, whose mind would you like to read?
My husband's. I always get a confusion. What he is doing, thinking, he will be in his own mind. So, I am really get confused.
Okay. So that was actually, I think all the wives wants to read their husband's mind.
100% I want to read my husband's mind. What he thinks always. He was keep on thinking all the time.
Okay.
I always ask him, what you're thinking? What you're thinking?
Yeah. That was lovely talking to you. I love talking to you. You know that.
But you know, I enjoyed. I was very nervous how I talk. I don't know. This is the first experience for me. Dancing on the stage, how many times you tell morning to night, I don't get scared especially. But how I talk, is it right way to talk or something? So you made me, it's very coolly. Thank you Work TV also. It's very nice.
That was wonderful, and it is so, you know, it is so appreciating that you're into, at this era, you're into so much into culture and they want to give so much life into this classical dance form. And it's very rare, you know, we get these sort of people, right? Because nowadays there are so many dance forms which is just disrupting like anything. So it's wonderful to have people like you around. So thank you for your time. Thank you for coming on my show. And thank you, viewers. Keep watching Voice. Keep watching my show. Have a very good evening. Bye.
Bye. Good evening.